Before we even begin, you should know one thing. This is a 360-degree video. You're either seeing it correctly or you're not seeing it correctly. In order to see it right and to take advantage of the whole 360-degree video, you need to ensure if you're on desktop, have Google Chrome, Firefox, or Opera. If you are on a mobile device, be sure that you are using the YouTube mobile app, or this is going to just look stretched out and it's not going to look right at all. So let's get started with my first 360-degree vlog. I decided I would purchase a 360-degree camera for a couple of reasons. Now, I don't plan on using them a lot of the times, but what I do plan on doing is sometimes I might do a tour, I might bring one to conventions, I might use them for certain projects where I think that you guys might want to look at whatever you want to look at as opposed to what I want you to look at. And in order to do that, I figured we could do it with a 360-degree camera. If you're on a mobile device and you're watching, you can kind of just move the screen around and turn, and you'll be able to see everything that I see from up and down. Or you can use your finger and swipe around. If you're on a desktop, laptop, or something like that, you can also just use your mouse to drag the screen around, and you can look wherever you want. 360-degree cameras have been out for a little while, but to come down to a consumer level, they still have some work to do. The audio is not going to be that great, and nor will the video. But it's definitely some cool technology, and while I don't plan to use it all the time, I will use it once in a while for some cool videos. If you're wondering why the tank is off, I don't know what the audio is going to be like on this camera, but I do know it's stereo, so it's not going to pick up just my voice, it's going to pick up all of the ambient noises as well. So until I get used to the camera and do some more testing, I'll just shut things off so it's easier just to hear me, because I don't think it's a great quality audio recorder in it. Let's go take a look outside and see what it looks like out there. Okay, so maybe this will give us a better idea of what it looks like out here. Not full sun. It's my house. Let you guys kind of look around. Maybe we'll go to the end of the driveway. It's always awkward filming because my neighbors don't know I do YouTube videos. And when local people find out, they just ask a ton of questions. So here is where I live. The bright out here. Good, good, good. So we got a little bit of snow. Now I guess I'll, so I live in a really humble house. Pretty small. Well, not small, it's good enough for my family. Two kids, two adults. We love it. This here, what we're walking up to, is where, okay, so there's some temperature. It's only -2 out right now, so it's not bad. It's actually really good snow too. This is excellent snow for building snowmen. Well, for the most part, it seems like it is. I think there's a train over there somewhere, as I hear it. So in here, this here is where I film my videos. I'll take you guys in for the first time. There. Is this the right one? Of course not. Is this it? Could be. Okay, so I don't know if you'll be able to see in here or not. It's going to be pretty dark. I'll flick on some lights, but they are CFL lights, so they take a little while to kind of heat up. This is where you'll see most of my videos filmed. There's a couple toolboxes on there right now because I was doing some filming in the, not filming, but fixing some stuff in the house. This is where I film, but you guys only see it framed in to see the white and the black. And then I adjust some camera settings to make it look like it's distant and dark and you'll only see me. Sort of thing. A lot of people think I got this big fancy studio, and I gotta tell you, I film in a dilapidated garage. This is actually tipped over some, it's not actually level, and it's not insulated. I don't know if you see my breath about in here a little bit. And sometimes it gets minus 20 in here, or sometimes in the summer it's really hot. But either way, I come out and I film no matter what. And I don't have fancy studios. I do everything myself. And I try to... I do my best out here. I do my best. I don't have a lot to work with, though. Yeah, that's it. Take a look at my backyard. Sounds like the neighbors are getting their snow plows ready. I'm ahead of the game. It's actually 3 o'clock in the afternoon right now. I gotta shut these lights off. So there you have it. I mean, there's nothing fancy here. I just do my best with what I've got, and that's it. I guess that's it. We should go back in because my wife is home now, and she hates when I film her. Maybe we can catch her on camera, the tail end of her. You hurry up. No, she's gone. That's my little car. Like I said, I need a truck. This is my basketball net. It's tall enough for me to dunk on, but my son can't. So I destroy him in the summertime. I'm such a bully. When you come back in, you gotta get nice and warm though. So I guess that's it. It's just a basic, real quick video that showed you guys some things, and maybe you got a little tour of this office. This is a temporary office with a lot of temporary things going on. So don't assume that this is the way it's always going to be. There's going to be some big changes happening in here. I know that you guys also want to see everything else that's going into my hobby, and that's what's coming up this Sunday. Now, for those that did watch the video on the topic that was called They Are Dead, I also made a podcast, and I consider it to be the extended version of that video. That video was titled They Are Dead because my rays were killed in a tragic event that happened about 8 months ago. This coming Sunday, I'm talking about everything that's happened since those 8 months, so bringing you guys up to speed. But the podcast that I did was basically everything that happened leading up to this event. So if you listen to the podcast, you'll get a much better idea of where I'm coming from with all of this. I'll leave a link in the description to the podcast, and as well as a pop-up will appear, and you guys can listen to it whenever you want. It's about an hour long, so make sure you have the time. So I do have one last question. What are some cool ideas that we could use this camera for? Let me know in the comments section below. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If not, come back next Thursday, and I'll have something different for you.